The second one-day international of this series found England looking to build on their remarkable performance at Edgbaston. New Zealand looking to bounce back. Brendan McCullum won the toss and chose to bat first on a very good pitch. Tim Southey returned for the Kiwis. England unchanged. Brendan McCullum got the side off to a very good start along with Martin Guptill before he fell for 39, 61 for one. Guptill was the next to go for exactly 50, but at halfway, New Zealand were 165 for two and well placed for a big score. Kane Williamson made 93, but the rock of the innings was Ross Taylor, who went through to 100 playing some fantastic shots. 119 not out in the end. Elliot and Ronke chipped in two. 398 for five, New Zealand. A huge chase for England then, but they made a very, very good start. Alex Hales and Jason Roy added 85 for the first wicket. Joe Root missed out today and England subsided to 100 for three before Owen Morgan led a fantastic fight back along with first Ben Stokes and then Joss Butler. But Morgan was eventually dismissed for 88, caught on the boundary by Elliott. England were 274 for six and looked to be in trouble. Sam Billings went cheaply, but Liam Plunkett and Adil Rashid added 70 for the eighth wicket. When sadly for this big crowd at the Oval, the rains came. It forced a delay of some 50 minutes. And when they resumed, England had a revised target of 34 runs to win from just 13 balls. Liam Plunkett fell to Nathan McCullum. But the killer blow for New Zealand was when Adil Rashid was dismissed remarkably by Tim Southey and Trent Boult, who combined for a catch on the boundary. And that ended England's hopes. They finally finished on 365 for nine. New Zealand winning under Duckworth-Lewis by 13 runs to square the series. The highest aggregate run total in a one-day international in England. A remarkable game. And this series will continue at Southampton on Sunday with the score one apiece.